The crabber's knot, or the crossed running knot. One advantage of this particular knot is, first of all, it's a slip knot, so we can actually adjust the size of the loop. However, if we want to turn it into a fixed loop knot, we pull that little end there and pull sharply on this one here, and it's now formed itself into a non-slipped loop knot.
Working end is coming towards me. The first thing that I do is I form a bite in my rope at that point there. Once I've formed a bite in my rope, I take the working end and pass it underneath around the back, just take enough room to tie the knot itself, and then the next thing I do is pass it over, under, then bring it round and pass it over that one there, take it underneath, and we've now tied ourselves the crabber's knot, or the crossed running knot.